Make a date with Rev Dr Ebenezer Markwei at 6 a.m. from Monday to Saturday on Graphic Online via Facebook and YouTube as he expounds on matters of faith.
Graphic Online, truth and accuracy every day.
This is Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Markwei of Living Streams International bringing you matters of faith with Graphic on a Christmas roll. You know, I'm just trying to bring the event of Christmas through a kaleidoscope of principles, through different shades of colors of principles. And for me, that's what matters most. It's not the event, but the principles invested in the event. That opens applicative windows for us so that we can apply them to our lives in a daily basis and we'll become winners and not losers. So yes, the focus of Christmas is Christ, but the focus of his birth is not just Christ. The focus of this then is the principles about his birth. Now in Matthew chapter 2, if you read, you remember the story of the wise men, a wise man from the east, and the Bible says they left this thing to come. So I'll capture today as wise geography. And it's these wise men left where they were and then they came to Jesus and they followed the star all the way to the manger. And for me, that's it. So number one, the Bible describes them as wise men. But there was something that was this thing. These people were stargazers. These people were stargazers. So they were used to reading the tables, they were reading to read the Ouija boards, the astronomers, astrologies, and all those other things. But the day they saw that star, the finality of all stars, the bright and morning star, no other star mattered anymore, but the Bible says they followed that particular star. Now listen, you may have any other persuasion you believe in, but there's only one bright and morning star. And that bright and morning star is Jesus. And listen, the test of the men that followed was a test of wisdom. They knew they had seen stars. They've seen the stars in the zodiac. They've seen the Orion. They've seen the Pleiades. They have seen the constellations. They have seen Pleiades, the Arcturus and the Mazaroth. They knew all those things. They knew the zodiac distance. But when they saw that bright and morning star, that Jesus star, the Bible says they left every other star to follow it. Listen, there's only one bright and morning star, and that bright and morning star is Jesus. And he is the one we need to follow. So we need to follow it. Yeah, astrology and all those, and they are there. But I can tell you this, my sure word, my sure comfort, my sure victory, my sure conquest is in Jesus and not in nothing else. For there's no other name under heaven given amongst men whereby we must be saved. So I would follow Jesus, no matter what it is. I'm following the bright and morning star. Come follow the bright and morning star with me. Now here's the next thing. The Bible called them wise men. So wise men are known by their thoughts, their speech, by their decisions, and by their actions. So by their thought, their speech, or when I say their thought, their perceptions, how they process things, and their thoughts, their philosophies, and then their speech, what they say, you know, and then by their actions, what they do. These are things that wise men are known for. And I said, they followed, that's number one. Number two, the Bible said, now when they came to Jesus, they said, this boy is different. Here was the thing. They said, this thing is different. Even though it is in a manger, even though the genesis of this baby is stinking and everything is not correct, let us make an investment into this baby. So it's the time they said, we are going to make an investment in this baby. And here is the investment they made. They gave myrrh, first gold, myrrh, and frankincense. Gold, myrrh, that is spices, myrrh, and frankincense. Now they brought gold. You know what they're saying? Even though this baby has been born in a very poor environment, we make an investment. We sow a seed into his destiny. We sow a seed into his future. This person is going to be the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. At the mention of his name, every knee must bow. The earth is going to be it and the fullness thereof. Earth is going to be his footstool. Heaven is going to be his throne. He is going to be walking on streets of gold. So we make an investment of gold. That means we are identifying with the poverty status of this child at this material moment, or this needy status of this child at the moment. So we are investing gold into him. Then Mer. Now Mer, you know, is something that deadens, is used to deaden pain. I mean, in olden times, we call it krobo. That is, it stops deterioration. I mean, we use it as a spice for embalming in those days, if you remember. Now, or if you remember, they'll tell you. So sometimes when we're kids, they say, hey, a ghost is here because they can smell mer. That is krobo. You know what they said? They said, this little boy is going to go through challenges. Let's invest in his suffering. Let's invest in the warfare he's going to have. Let's make provision for him, for the things that he's going to go through, and ease the pain, and ease his challenges, and ease his issues. Then they brought in frankincense. Anytime they talk about frankincense, it talks about Jesus. But here's the interesting thing. It smells nice. It smells nice. So they said, there's something stinking about this boy. There's something stinking about this beginning. Let's make it smell nice. Let's make it smell better. That is, brighten the corner where we are. Ease the pain. Do something. Make an investment in an environment. Maybe you need to pick up yourself and go back to your church and look at the things that are taking place over there. Find a way to brighten the life of somebody, brighten the life of your church. Make the place smell nice. Is that the place is already stinking? We are not going to add to the stench. We are rather going to do something to make the place smell nice. So there are some of us, when we go to places and things are bad, we add to the rottenness. We add to the deterioration. We add to the corruption. Somebody said, oh, well, they've chopped everything. We will take stones and flint and scrape the bottom part of the pan and scrape the underbelly of the rice. But they said, listen, something is not right over here. We're going to make it look better. It's a choice you have to make. Are you a wise man or not? See you later.